When natural disasters like hurricanes hit, the technology we rely on to communicate can get cut off. But a new tool is emerging that could keep you on the grid.
We're talking about a radio, but it's much different than the one inside your car. Gulf Coast News reporter Alex Howard spoke with local pioneers of the technology about how it works to keep you safe during an emergency.
The more devices that we have, the more powerful, more reliable the system will be.
When visiting Dana Dash of Cape Coral, the first thing we noticed was the antenna on his roof. And it's not for satellite TV or internet.
It's called Meshtastic. It's actually an off-grid communications protocol. There's no license required. It uses LoRa band technology radio to connect your cell phone to the LoRa band to other devices on the network.
He's one of a literal network of independent operators who've connected themselves using a new kind of tech on an old radio frequency.
Which is not really used a whole lot anymore. It used to be the cell phones, the old cell phones used to use the ISM band. The FCC's relaxed it and they've given it to us to use license free.
Unlike ham radio operators, you don't need a license to use these. And as Dash says, he sees this as a failsafe against a hurricane-caused outage, like what happened after Ian.
When the hurricane happens, I'm out. I know where there's fuel. I know where there's water. I know where there's pretty much anything that are necessities to people that don't have any communications at all. They can't call somebody and say, hey, have you found where there's gas? Is McDonald's open? So we can broadcast this over the network to anybody that has a node in Cape Coral, North Fort Myers.
Meshtastic uses low-frequency radio waves to send messages between devices, unlike a cell phone, which relies on cell towers. So when the grid is down, you can still get a message out. All you have to do is type in a message into an app connected by Bluetooth to one of these nodes connected to the network.
And the higher the node, the greater the range.
A node like this has the ability to travel approximately 100 miles. So one hop, 100 miles is a pretty, if I can make it to Miami, you know, that it could definitely find another node down there that would limit how many hops it would be needed to send the message to where it needs to go.
I carry this one in my wallet every day.
Ben Giddens of Cape Coral is a licensed ham radio operator. He sees it as a tool in the event of a disaster.
It was used in eastern Tennessee after Hurricane Helene. A local communications specialist deployed about 120 radios to volunteers that were doing search and rescue, communication between churches and other depots where aid was being rendered.
Once you buy a node, you're connected to what's called the mesh, which you can see here. These nodes help forward messages to other nodes.
Probably about 10,000 users in the United States. I've seen about 400 online in Florida at any one time.
Either sent publicly or privately, hopping up to 7 times.
You can have private encrypted communications from radio to radio device without ever touching the cellular network or the internet.
If one or more nodes go down, the others that are still active can still send and receive messages.
It's open source. It's not commercialized. There's not somebody that can just pull the plug and shut the whole system down. It's, like I said, it's powered by the people. The more people, the more power.
Reporting in Cape Coral, Alex Howard, Gulf Coast News.